Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here, still in North Carolina for a little bit longer. The Lord, well, those of you who follow my ministry, the biggest change that came to my ministry since I started probably was Joshua's ministry that the Lord gave me commission for back in August of 2012. Well, the Lord just gave me a new commission as of this morning when I woke up. Brothers and sisters, I had a dream that I want to tell you about. And then you'll know if you watch this video in your regular fall Joshua's ministry. Just like the death of my stepson Joshua that led to the, you know, the fulfillment of all the things the Lord had told me about making orphanages and the feeding programs, which I'd already been doing. Orphans I'd already had. I already had all those things, but unorganized. And I had orphans with different pastors, had feeding programs here and there. Then with the death of Joshua, the Lord gave me a new mandate to bring forward the Joshua's ministry, which is a little child shall lead them. And that, you know, suffer little children to come unto me and forbid them not. Those are the Bible verses that the Lord gave me, and it was a mandate and a commission. And the Lord has been, you know, if you've been following me, the beginning of this year, the Lord gave me, you know, the word that he would start opening the doors into churches for me. The Lord led me to start making the videos of giving people a word, because I'd already been giving people words, but just here and there and not publicly. And so the same thing is true now, what I'm about to tell you, brothers and sisters. I've already been doing this stuff, but it's going to be up front. I had a dream, brothers and sisters, that was a life changer and a ministry changer for me. And I already know this stuff, right? But it's, you know, when the Lord quickens it, he quickens it. So, the word, the Bible verse for this dream, brothers and sisters, I'll give you up front, is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And it says, but sudden destruction, you know, shall come upon them like a flood, and they shall not escape. They shall not escape. Sudden destruction is coming, brothers and sisters. And from now on, by the grace of God, that's my new commission, to cry out and spare not, that sudden destruction is coming like a flood. I got more videos to make. And every video I make, even though I've already been on this theme, brothers and sisters, in all my ministry, that we're living in the end times, people need to get right because it's time for the rapture, it's time for the tribulation and all that. But it's become, the Lord is organizing that and focusing that in the ministry, brothers and sisters. So those of you who watch my videos, just know that. Going forward, the videos that I make, you'll know what is the motive in my heart from the Lord for the preaching that I do, which, it's, like I said, it's already been that way, but it's going to be organized. Let me tell you about this dream. In my dream, brothers and sisters, it was definitely from the Lord. 100%. It woke me up. I have, you know, I don't have that many dreams from the Lord. Everybody has dreams, but very few that are really definitely 100% from the Lord. This is one of those. It woke me up. It woke me up. And I jumped up, you know. Then I heard that Bible verse, what I just quoted to you from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, that sudden destruction shall come upon them like a flood. Excuse me, and they shall not escape. Anyway, I was in this house, brothers and sisters, and I was in the United States, and I was actually, and my wife has an aunt, her daddy's first cousin, lives in Texas, and she is a widow, her children are grown, and she is a serious Christian, and you know, the Lord has lined it up, because my mother-in-law died in 2008, and then my father-in-law died, if you've been following my videos, so my wife's, she's, you know, in the Philippines, that you call your parents' cousins your aunts and uncles too. That's how they do it. So, and they're considered as an aunt and an uncle, and that's how they treat them. So anyway, my wife's aunt, you know, wants to get with us. And because she's a serious Christian, she's a widow and all that, it's just perfect because my wife has no parents anymore. She's a stranger in this country. It's awesome that she would have an aunt, you know, to befriend her and help her learn to get her to drive, to get her driver's license, and all those things that takes a lot of time and patience, and, you know, it's just perfect. Perfect for us. It's really a blessing from the Lord. So, anyway, in my dream, we were at her house. We were at her house, and she lives in Texas. So, you know, by the grace of God, at the end of July, I'll be going to Texas. But I will be, the Lord spoke to me, too, also today, that to go to Seattle. I'll be Seattle, Portland, and Vancouver. I guess I'll go to all three, but I know I'll be going to Seattle, and I may go out to Vancouver too, and Portland, based out of Seattle, for 2 weeks, the first 2 weeks, I think, or the second and third week in August. contact me if you're in those three areas. Let's set it up. Anyway, I was in her house. So that, you know, I'm going to be there in August. I'm saying that because to tell you that I will be there in August, the first week of August, and then I'll go to Seattle and Portland and Vancouver for 2 weeks. And then by the grace of God, I'll be back the third week of August, back in the Dallas area, the greater Dallas area, near Dallas. And I'll be there, I don't know, to the end of the year, maybe. I mean, it's up to the Lord. I'm going to still go to places and visit, but I'm talking about I have a home base in the greater Dallas area. Okay, so in my dream, I was there in that place, brothers and sisters, which I'll be. January, we're going to the Philippines for 2 months. You know, and I don't know if we'll go back to Dallas or how long we'll stay in Dallas. I don't know that. But anyway, it was in Dallas, in the United States, brothers and sisters. And this is important because it's about the United States in particular, but everywhere, but particularly there's importance in my spirit about the United States. The Lord is just speaking some more stuff to me just a minute ago, and I'm trying to remember what it is, but as the Lord brings it up to me, I'll come out. Okay. So in my dream, brothers and sisters, I was in the house, her house, and there was lots of people there. Americans and Filipinos. This woman, of course, like my wife, is a Filipino. She has lots of Filipino friends who she's been trying to mentor. Another part of the Lord sending me to connect with her is because they don't have a pastor. It's like a home Bible study group. I've started three Filipino churches as home Bible study groups. So I will start a new group with them or work with that group and be their pastor. And then one day when I leave or whatever happens, or the Lord, if the Lord tarries, they become a group, a church, whatever. And then I'm going to start another night for anybody else that wants to come. You know, I have like a Friday and Saturday night, two home churches. I already mentioned that before. I'll be starting two home churches in the area of Texas, Friday and Saturday night. Really one for the Filipino people and then one for everybody else. Of course, they can go vice versa, whatever. A lot of people who are immigrants, they don't want to talk in front of other people unless it's their own group. This is pretty standard with all immigrant groups. That's why you see, like in New York City, you see these different immigrant neighborhoods, Chinatown, Little Italy, all that. People like to segregate into their own group when they're foreigners. You know, United States is one of the only countries in the world we have people from all over the place. Other countries, they're not used to being around other people, so it takes time for them to, you know, to open up their experiences with other people. So there were people in this house, white people, black people, Filipino people, all kinds of people. Even some gay people that were, you know, just, I want to put that out. There were gay people there who were coming to a Bible study. Anyway, that, you know, they want to get saved. In my dream, I was going through the house trying to have a moment's peace, which is what I'm doing now. I was trying to hide and have a moment's peace and quiet so I could think and things like that. And my wife was there too. And I said, let's go in this other room here so I can be away from people. And there were people in that room. Went to another room, there were people in there. And the thing about it is, brothers and sisters, every room I went to, there was some water in the floor. And then I said to myself, well, there must be some kind of a busted water pipe here and under the floor, and the water is seeping through. And I was like, you know, surely my wife's aunt knows about this, so I don't need to tell her. So I went to another room, and there was water there. Every room I went to, there was water, but there were people sleeping, there were people talking, there were people doing all kinds of activity. No one was paying attention to this water. Okay. So I finally went into the living room, and there was lots of people there, like a main area, because I decided that, hey, maybe I need to tell my wife's aunt that, hey, this water, because it looked like it was getting a little bit deeper everywhere. I was like, well, I better go tell her. You know, so I told my wife, I said, let's go into the living room. Went into the living room, and there was water there. And then, I had been talking to my wife about the water, and then she's like, look, I think it's getting deeper. And I looked, and then it suddenly began to surge more deeply. And then I began to shout and say, the place is flooding, get out, get out, get out of the house, get out of the house, this place is flooding, get out, get out, get out. And then I told my wife, you know, go tell your aunt that the house is flooding, everybody needs to get out. Tell everybody to get out of the house. And so I was yelling that. And after I started yelling, then everybody was paying attention. So, you know, interpretation is that, yeah, we've been having tribulation. We've been having trouble. We've been seeing the rise of the New World Order. We've been seeing the rise of false doctrine of Chrislam and all this other stuff. What the new Pope is doing. We see this rise of a whole new level of false doctrine and false teaching and integrating and mixing Christianity with Islam, all this stuff. We see the Pope is taking a leadership role in that. We already saw the Protestant guy, the Saddleback guy. The Pope already appeared on a big screen there to Kenneth Copeland and all them, you know, and trying to unite all of those guys. Let's compromise all of our doctrines. No matter what you believe about doctrines, you know, these guys are ready to compromise everything in the name of love, mankind's love, not the love of Christ. They want to do it with Islam and everything else and say, oh, we all have the same God. Allah is God, the same as the God of the Bible. It's all the same, blah, blah, blah. This is the lie of the false prophet, and this is the lie of the Antichrist. This is not, you know, all religions are exclusive. I mean, you know, by definition, all religions are exclusive. You know, they have a teaching. This is our teaching. This is what makes us a group. Now, you can compromise on lots of things, but if you really believe, you know, Jesus is the only way, then that's something that you can't compromise on. If you compromise on that, you've thrown out Christianity. Anyway, so that's another thing about this water. It was dirty, muddy water. Anyway, so with those people, brothers and sisters, I opened the front door of the house, and there was all the people were following me. I was like, get out of the house, get out of the house, get out of the house. Of course, the house represents the church. Get out, get out, get out. We went outside. As soon as I opened the door, I stepped out, and then I saw a wall of muddy water, brothers and sisters. Turbulent, muddy water coming from every direction. Okay? And then when I realized that there's no safety when we went outside the house. But, brothers and sisters, there was, the water was like one story high. Okay? It was like to the top of one story. But on the side of the house that I was in, and I looked at all the houses in the neighborhood. Listen to me. Outside of every house, and the Lord, I'm emphasizing this because the Lord emphasized this. In my dream, I wasn't sure all the details. I've been praying about it all day. That's why I'm just making a video now. It's like 10 o'clock at night here. And, you know, I've been praying about it all day, the interpretation and understanding of all the details. Outside of every house, there was old wooden steps. Old wooden, like a wooden cross, like the old paths. Like we talked about in Jeremiah, I made a video. You guys watch the video that I made where the Lord prompted in my spirit about following the old paths. I think it's Jeremiah chapter 9. I could be wrong. Anyway, Jeremiah chapter 11 or something. Following the old paths. You know, go back into the old way. We're talking about the cross. We're talking about the way, the truth, and the life. We're talking about Jesus Christ. Okay, follow those old paths. And it was old wooden steps, like a wooden cross, going up to the top of the house we were in. Okay? And then every other house, I saw some people, very few people, from every house made it up those wooden steps onto the top of each house. But in my dream, it's like I'd got separated from my wife, and I was like calling for her, and I was like, I should not send her away from me to go find her aunt. I should have had her with me. I wasn't thinking, you know, I didn't know it was going to be such sudden destruction. So, you know, that's personal for me. You know, I keep my wife close to me, keep her in her walk with the Lord, and keep her close in her relationship with the Lord. But so here's the thing about it. And that was the end of my dream. I heard my son crying because he was with my wife. And then, boom, I woke up. Here's the point, brothers and sisters, for the body of Christ, for us. You've got to get, and I made videos about it before. You have to get outside the people-pleasing palaces. You have to come out from among them. That's what the Bible says. Come out from among them and be ye holy. For God is holy. I believe that's 1st or 2nd Peter. And it's also a quote from the Old Testament. Come out from among them. You know, arise thou that sleepest. You know, and Christ will give you life. That's the problem with the lukewarm people. That's my video, is for the lukewarm, backslidden Christian. You know, everybody's got their different calling. And of course we evangelize, and I'm evangelizing and all that too. But it's the backslidden, lukewarm, sleepy Christian that God has called me to. You are about to miss the rapture. So here's the word I have from the Lord for you. And this is the word the Lord gave me. Now, I talked about the sudden destruction is coming, and that's the warning to the world and the warning to everybody. But the instructions, the warning is, sudden destruction is coming like a flood, and you will not escape unless you come up higher. That's the only way to escape, is to come up higher. That's what, in my dream, when I saw that, I was telling the people, you got to go higher. You know, I didn't add that part. You got to go higher. You got to go higher. I was telling them to go higher. Telling them to go higher, higher, higher. And then in my dream, I saw, hey, I realized that my wife wasn't with me. So that's personal for me. I need to make sure I keep my wife right with me and that she will go up higher too. You know, and that's for all of us. Almost every person that watches my YouTube videos, that I talk to, almost 100%, they are awake, but their spouse is at the minimum, a lukewarm Christian. Lots of them are anti-Christian, militantly anti-Christian, anti-Holy Spirit, you know, anti the things of God, anti-end times, almost 100% of the viewers of my videos. I bet less than 10% husband and wife are walking in agreement. And that's one reason why lots of people are on YouTube instead of going to a Spirit-filled church. Not only because a Spirit-filled truth-preaching church is hard to find, but because their spouse is not in agreement with them anyway. So, you know, how can two walk together except they're in agreement? So their only way of getting ministered to is through YouTube. Besides the fact that there's few churches, they don't have that, you know, family agreement and togetherness. Anyway, brothers and sisters, now you know and hear from my own mouth what is the motive. I got two or three more videos to make, and the Lord has given me wisdom and information. All day the Lord's been dropping a wisdom on me all day about this, about what I need to preach and what I need to say. So sudden destruction is coming, brothers and sisters, and there's 90% of people will not escape that coming. It was muddy water and turbulent water, not just the tribulation, but for what we're talking about is this, you know, for Christians, it's this strong delusion. It's this false doctrine. It's this Chrislam. It's this, you know, mixing of the religions. You know the word Arab, the name Arab, Arabo, Arab means mixed. Mixed. Now, I'm not talking about the people. But even out of Islam, it's mixed, it's a muddled, it's dirty water. This religion that's coming out of that area, okay, and this bringing in, muddying up the waters in the whole world, brothers and sisters, I'm telling you, sudden destruction is coming. And the only way to escape is that old, wooden, narrow way that leads to go up higher, to the top. As a matter of fact, the Lord just spoke to me now. He mentioned this to me a few hours ago, and I is just calling it back to my memory. Do you know what? When you get to the top of those old wooden steps, the old wooden steps I saw all look like that old red painted ones you see people have on the back of their house. And when I was asking the Lord about it this afternoon when I was doing my jogging, you know, that's the time I meditate the most. When I try to jog and to think clearly and meditate on the word of the Lord. And the Lord just told me, that's right. What color was those steps? It's the same color as a sun deck. The same color as a sun deck is what the Lord told me. You know, so when you go up those steps, brothers and sisters, up to the top of the house, just like in those houses they have in Israel, when Jesus said, you know, Jesus talked about, you know, don't come down from the rooftop. People used to go up there at night and stuff, just like Jesus talked to Nicodemus. They say on top of a house. So when you go up on top of a house, brothers and sisters, in the Middle East or like in Israel, you know, it's like people hang out up there at nighttime and stuff when it's not hot. So in this thing that I'm saying to you is that when you went up those narrow steps to go up higher, to get above that tribulation, to get above that muddy, turbulent water, you were standing on a sun deck. You were standing in the sun. You were standing with the sun, right? So to come up higher and be in the presence of the Lord, that is the only way to escape, brothers and sisters. And so that's what's going to be motivating me from now on, or until the Lord changes my commission, until his return. The motivation, brothers and sisters, is to tell people of the sudden destruction coming, and there's only one way to escape. That's to go up higher in Christ, the narrow way, brothers and sisters. Okay, I'll be back with more videos right now.